is all that I can give to you.
Well, I can give you more than that. I can give you an ode to Ruth. There was once a girl called Ruth who, when I saw her, made me go struth. Smart, witty, and lovely as hell, head over heels in love I fell. On bended knee I did propose, to which she replied, oh, I suppose. Down the aisle I whisked her.
You did whisk me.
Before she could get away. But lucky old me, because we're still here today. I'm saying all this because Valentine's Day.
Well, I know that.
And despite a man called Anton who tried to steal your heart, no amount of sequence could ever keep us apart. So despite the odd quarrel for the whole wide world to see, it is you, Ruth Langsford, who's the only girl for me.
Aw, thank you, darling. I was a bit worried because you hadn't left me a card this morning. But is
Ruthie,
that why?
Ruthie left me a present this morning.
I left you a very nice. Happy Valentine's Day, everybody, by the way.
There was a beautiful bag beside my bed on the table. And it was all done in lovely red tissue paper and little hearts all over and everything. And I delved into it and I took out a plastic bag.
It's not a plastic bag.
Container. A see-through sort of makeup bag thing.
It's not a makeup bag. You're being unkind.
I'm not doing it. I'm just simply asking, what has that got to do with Valentine's Day?
Well, yeah, I go, well, I could have got you chocolates. You don't need chocolate. What else could I have got you, right? So, when we travel together, we go through airports, you know when you've got little toiletries and things, and then you have to put them into that funny plastic bag, and you moan. Oh, I've got to put all this in the plastic bag. Great expense, bought a proper bag with leather around it that's airport security tested, so that when you're at home, you put it all in there, you have to take it out, and it's all in your hand luggage.
Just let me get this straight. So your way of showing me that you love
someone's
and adore
laughing
me,
in my ear. Stop that.
That you love and adore me.
Yes.
Is to get my anticipation up. This lovely romantic heart-shaped bag.
Yes.
Red tissue paper in it, and inside it is a plastic Tupperware.
It's not Tupperware. It's a beautiful. It's leather and things. It's very expensive. What did you hope would be in there?
Well, I can't say on air, but
what did you want? Like a thong or something with red hearts on it or something? What did you want in there? What were you hoping to find?
Well, I didn't get it, so let's put it that way.
Well, please back me up, somebody. So I just thought it's a nice practical present that's very useful. You'll always have it. And every time you go through the airport, you'll go, oh,
and what did I get
that.
You?
Nothing yet.
Yeah, yet. Is the
well, I'm hoping
word,
there's it, yeah. Nothing yet.
The thing is, I know your every move today. I know you will be. All I'm going to say to you is be on your guard all day. Okay?
Did but you really hate my present that much?
I'm just puzzled by it.
I'm a bit hurt.
I'm puzzled. I mean, it'd be the equivalent of me buying you an iron or a brush or a mop and say, have some fun today, darling.
You bought me a lovely travel blanket thing that all goes into things. You know, I get cold.
That's Christmas.
Yeah, but that's a practical present and it's still lovely because it's thoughtful. Thoughtful. Somebody agreed with me. It's like an echo with the women. Thoughtful, thoughtful, thoughtful.
That's thoughtful.
You didn't flipping write that. Did you write that? Did you really write it?
And do you know, whatever you get today, you'll think, did he write that? What do you call me?
My poet, darling.
There you are. My case rests.
He does. Thank He's very romantic. Today. Anyway, happy Valentine's Day to you.
And to everyone who sent me all those cards, thank you so very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mrs. Holmes, for sending that for him.
What are we talking about?